So here's a classical use case for spacer and geometry reader. I want to have this orange color here, but I only want it to be in the center third of this view. So usually people would also use UI screen.bounce for this, but imagine that you don't want to have the center third of the screen, you want to have the center third of this view. So how would you usually implement this? So you would grab the color and probably embed it in an H stack and then put a spacer both in front and behind the color. But you will notice that this doesn't actually push the color to the center of the view, as color is greedy and will expand to the largest size possible, and the spacers can't basically contain it in the center third. So what people then do is grab the H stack and embed it in a geometry reader. Geometry reader. And then they get the geometry proxy and apply a frame to the color. So you would, for example, apply a frame with a width of the proxy.size.width divided by 3. So you want to have the color 1/3 of the size. So this is basically the exact result that I wanted, and this now works in any container, no matter how wide it is. So if we gave this VStack a width of, let's say, 200 points, then you will notice that the geometry reader gets tighter as well. Now this is why we're using geometry reader here instead of UI screen. But of course, this is quite a lot of code just to have a simple color with 1/3 of the size here. Let me propose to you a different solution that takes less code, is more readable, and doesn't have to use a geometry reader, which is known for bad performance. So instead of this approach, I will use a color dot red, for example. And I hope you can see it nicely here in the preview. Now, what we're going to use is a new iOS 17 API that is called containerRelativeFrame. It has a bunch of different initializers or overloads, method signatures. In our case, we will use the one where we specify the horizontal axis, because this modifier allows us to specify the frame of our view that we apply it to relative to the frame of the containing view. So in this case, the containing view is this VStack. The view that we want to specify the frame of is this red color. So we only care about the horizontal frame. We could do this for both vertical and horizontal. And then in here, we get a size, or let's call it length. And then you also get the axis back in case you care about both vertical and horizontal. Now, in our case, we don't care about this axis parameter, so we can get rid of it. And then all we have to do is implicitly return the size that we want to have as our horizontal frame for this view. So we want to use the length, which is the horizontal frame of our containing view, meaning the VStack. And you can see right now, this would mean that the red color uses 100% of the width, but we can now divide that by 3, which means that the red color only uses 1/3 of the width. Now you can imagine how useful this container relative frame modifier is in a bunch of different places. This is just one of the simplest applications of it. And just to quickly show to you again, there are different overloads of this modifier. So for example, one where you can also add a count and a span. Now these are overloads that you can play around with in your own time. The most basic version here specifies an axis, and then you get a closure where you compute your size along this axis. Essentially, you can imagine this being a built-in geometry reader into a view modifier.